Welcome to the 2017 Park Row Parade.
Hi, I'm Renee McHugh.
And I'm Rob Rawlson.
You know, this parade started in 1998 with the road completion project. And today, the parade still celebrates everything that's great about West Hartford. Its neighborhoods, its businesses, its architecture. And so here we are to celebrate once again.
Today you're going to see more than 70 contingents in the 19th annual parade. Some of these contingents are zany, some of them are musical,
yes.
And some have a more serious message that they'd like to bring to you.
Yes.
One thing they all have in common, they love Park Road and they love this parade, Renee.
Absolutely. And these participants will be judged today by Darlene Zoller, and Rick Fountain of Playhouse on Park, and they're right over there on the showmobile. And awards will be given out today for best overall performance, best float, best costume, best musical performance, and best community spirit. We will announce the winners at the end of the parade.
How about best commentators?
I should think. Here we go.
The Park Road Parade clowns are here today under the direction of Jody Mock. The West Hartford clowns have been participating in this parade since the very beginning.
Yes.
The clowns make up a parade of participation for the viewers on the sidelines. They drag them into the parade.
Yes.
They give them a good time and they give them a good show. You're also going to see Trevor the games man.
Yep. Walking on his stilts.
Walking on his big tall stilts. It's a thrill to watch him do his thing.
And the 2017 Grand Marshal this year is Heidi Voigt. She's the morning news anchor on NBC Connecticut. And of course, we have to recognize all the volunteers that go into a parade of this magnitude. And you'll see them leading divisions today. You'll see them running around with radios on the stage, in golf carts, behind the scenes. And you can spot them wearing those nice orange Park Road Parade t-shirts.
Well, it's amazing how many hundreds or thousands of hours go into putting this together. Next year's parade begins immediately after this one finishes noon today.
That's right.
Start then.
Yes, and we also need to thank our sponsors. Without their support, this parade most certainly would not be possible.
Let me give you the names of some of our title sponsors.
Yes.
That would be Effie's Place Family Restaurant, a longtime restaurant on Park. Great place to do a meeting. Laz Parking, Zest 280, the Webster Bank. Our other sponsors would include the Connors Insurance Agency, E.J. Haverty Construction, Daly's Corner Package Store, which has also been here since the beginning of time, Joey's Pizza Pie. Pizza Pie is always a favorite on Park Road. Lovely Development, Inc., Mark Roaming Associates, Mr. Sparkle Car Wash, Open Arms Christian Ministries, and a new restaurant on the Avenue, Park and Oak Restaurant.
Yes.
Joined up as a sponsor this year. And, of course, ShopRite.
And ShopRite. And also for the month of October, bring your bottles and cans to ShopRite. Get your nickel for their redemption and donate to the Park Row Parade.
Oh, that's so nice of them to do that.
Oh,
yeah, what
absolutely.
A great deal.
Continuing on with our sponsors, we have Simsbury Bank, Thomas Fahey Insurance, Udolph Properties, United Bank, West Farms Mall, West Hartford Chamber of Commerce, and West Hartford Police Association. And our in-kind sponsors are Fresh Ink, Stebbin Auto Body, Go Media, and the Town of West Hartford.
Well, Renee, let's get ready to see the contingencies come marching down the street, listen to the music, enjoy the clowns, and tell the rain to stay away. We have a beautiful day.
That's right. Here comes the first division. Be the American Legion Color Guard. And the American Legion is the nation's largest wartime veterans service organization, committed to mentoring youth, advocating patriotism, promoting strong national security, and continued devotion to our fellow service members and veterans.
Well, Renee, they're back there a little bit down the road. I'm sure we've got them on the camera. They're being led by a West Hartford police cruiser. And the American Legion over there on Raymond Road. And they do a great job for our veterans. They're advocates for the veterans. It's a great place for veterans to go find other people who have similar interests and in-kind understandings of their life as a military personnel. And I have a lot of friends that are members of the Legion. It's a great place. People should think about joining if they haven't.
Yes.
They really find a lot of support from that organization.
Yes, they could actually use some younger folks to kind of keep the mission of the American Legion going.
Yeah, they do need some younger guys, younger than me.
That's right.
So they're moving up. They're going to be followed by Park Road Business Association. But we won't get into them just yet. We're going to let this first contingent move along. They seem to have hit a roadblock down there.
But you know what? The crowds, the spectators are filling in along the sidelines here. People of all ages. It's so festive. We got balloons
I think we make the same comment every year. 5 minutes before the parade, I hope somebody's coming to this parade. And just before the parade begins, everybody shows up.
It seems
to be kind of the tradition here on Park Road. But I think we have a lovely crowd. I know the crowd will be thicker down at the other end where the parade starts.
Sure.
So up here we have a good-sized crowd all the way up to Quaker Lane.
Yes. Yeah. Yep. And our showmobile, our stage over here, the review stand, we'll see some acts and some performances in front of the review stand today. That'll be lots of fun. The people show off their talents.
Well, I see Darlene Zoller up there, who you've mentioned, and Rick Fountain, who you've mentioned. They are very involved in Park Road and in the Park Road and the Playhouse on Park.
Exactly.
And
yes.
I have to tell you, that little organization has brought such life to our community. I went the other day, and Barb and I went and saw Q the other day.
Avenue Q.
Did you like it?
Sold out.
So it is. They had waiting lines last night to get in there. It is a fabulous little play. Extreme talent at the highest level. I was overwhelmed. We brought friends that had never been to the Playhouse before, who go to a lot of theater, and they really loved it. They had a great time.
Good.
So it's just one of the little hidden gems in West Hartford, and happens to be located on this road.
Now in its ninth season.
Can you imagine? Playhouse on Park, 9 years old.
My goodness.
And they only live by donations, ticket sales, and the kindness of all of their friends. So we should mention that.
Yes.
If you're looking for a place for a tax deduction this year, maybe the Playhouse on Park is a good thought.
Absolutely. Certainly is.
Okay.
Certainly is.
Here comes the American Legion.
Yes.
They're representing the colors today.
Yes. American flag, Connecticut flag, and the American Legion flag.
Yeah. That would be right.
Yes. Okay.
And if it's wrong, we'll see it when it comes by us, because they're still out there. How many years we've been doing this, Renee?
Boy, this is the 19th annual, and it's pretty much since the beginning.
Yeah,
pretty much.
I know I've missed a few years, but things have come up, and you have too. But we try never to miss it, because it's a good civic job to have, and it's a lot of fun to have it.
It's a lot of fun. Immediately following the American Legion is our police administration. We have Police Chief Tracy Gove with Assistant Chiefs Robert McHugh and Danny Coppinger.
It's good to see the brass out today. Coming up behind the chief's administrative officers, we're starting off. First real contingent is the Park Road Association. Today they are represented by John Panderas and Tracy Flader, two stalwarts on our street. Tracy's with the Playhouse, and John, of course, is with Effie's Restaurant. Gentlemen, here come the.
There.
The Playhouse Association initiated this parade in 1998,
yes,
Renee.
Did.
And it was just to celebrate the completion and rebuilding of this terrific road. Their mission is to make sure businesses and residents and customers of the area have a warm, welcoming, and comfortable place to go to, someplace that's safe and good for the community.
And you got to come down to Park Road, because it is thriving and filled with so many great businesses, restaurants, and things to do.
Oh, here comes Tracy Flader now.
Here she comes now.
Hi, honey.
Big kisses.
Morning.
Good to see you guys. Good to see you guys. Always.
Okay, and here comes our elected officials. We have our new town manager, Matt Hart, with his daughter.
Oh, is that our new? Yeah, I met him a couple of weeks ago.
Yes.
Yeah, seems like he's fitting into the job and taking right over with things.
Good. We also have Mayor Sherry Cantor. I see Judy Kasperson, Derek Slapp.
Derek Slapp's there, Andrew Fleischman,
I
think, is there.
Ben Wollingrad.
Ben Wollingrad is there. It's a great day. It's a great day. Oh, there goes Mayor Cannon. What a lot of fun today is, huh? Owen Egan back there.
Andy Fleischman.
Representative Davidoff.
Probate Court, Owen Egan.
Hi, guys.
Jay Sarsen.
How are you
doing?
Good, Owen.
Chris Barnes, Chris Williams, Denise Hall.
Hi, guys.
How you
doing? Nice to see you. Denise Hall and Chris Williams. Mr. Davidoff.
How are you?
And Leon Davidoff and Beth Bye. Here comes our Grand Marshal. Her name is Heidi Voigt. Okay, and Heidi, you can see Heidi on NBC Connecticut Morning News from 4 to 7 a.m. in the morning. She is a resident of West Hartford. And she has lots of community spirit.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that is why we picked her as the Grand Marshal this year.
Here comes the Conard High, ninth graders, and the Sedgwick Middle School Band. A combined opportunity for both schools to get together.
And
let's
listen. Led by Scott Porter.
Want to listen? I just want to comment, as the band drifts off, the combined band, that's a big band, and they play well.
There's about 90 students in that
contingent. 90 students. They do a great job. And you're right. Here's the King Philip Middle School. It's great to see all the families and teachers out and everybody. Nice to see everybody. Yeah, there you go. There you go.
Happy Parade Day.
They have all their great shirts on, too. Nice to see you, brother.
John Larson.
Yes, Representative John Larson. Good morning, sir. Thank you. Thank you for coming to our parade. Thank you.
And here is the teacher of the year. His name is Luis Ramirez, and he's in Red Shrews 1972 Pontiac Granville. Mr. Ramirez is from Smith School. He's here with his children today.
He's got a load of people with him.
Highly regarded.
He's having fun in that beautiful
district.
Car.
Yes, yes.
Greatest job in the world.
Followed by
the Special Olympics. West Hartford Special Olympics. They got caught right up. The best job. Hi, guys. Hi. Hi, everybody. Thank you. All right.
You know, the West Hartford Special Olympics is sports and so much more. It's a movement that transforms lives by inspiring inclusion, understanding, and respect for people of all ages and abilities. And, you know, the athletes that walked by had lots of medals, and they participated in 11 different sports.
Just like anybody else, especially kids. It's great for them. Here comes the Hartford Marathon Foundation. Big day, big run, big fun. Cheer on the volunteers of the 24th Annual Eversource Hartford Marathon. Next Saturday, October the 14th.
Yes. Yes.
And while it's the Hartford Marathon, they do run part of it through West Hartford.
Yes. Right. Over 7,000 runners come through.
7,000 runners.
7,000
It's become
runners.
An elite
come into
event.
West Hartford.
Yep. They certainly have loud music.
Oh, yes.
Shriners.
We have the False Alarmers, Sphinx Shriners, always a parade favorite.
The Sphinx Shriners, they're called the False Alarmers, and I see why.
Yeah.
I think we all see why.
Yes. You know, they're here in support of the Shriners Hospital, and that is in 22 different locations throughout the United States and in different countries.
Well, they do a wonderful job. I can't ever remember, even growing up as a kid, and that was a long time ago, the Shriners were always helping the kids.
Yes.
Especially the burn unit kids.
Yes, yes. Regardless of your ability to pay, they will help the children
yep.
for specialized care.
Let's hope he doesn't run out of gas here, Renee.
Followed by the Sphinx Shriners Brass Band. This is always a favorite too. We have a sawed-off school bus carrying the brass band.
Yeah. This is the band coming up in this very Jamaican-looking bus to me. So you should think about the islands and what a place to go visit. But they seem to have all the spirit with them in this band truck.
So this band was formed in 1899. 1899, one of the oldest continually performing Shriner bands in the country. Isn't that amazing?
Well, that is amazing. Let's see if we can hear them.
Okay, yeah.
Beautiful music. And next up come the Knights of Columbus. This is a Catholic fraternal organization that supports its priests and bishops and does charitable work throughout our community. The Color Guard marches in a cross formation symbolic of their Christian faith. All decked out in their beautiful capes and their robes. Oh, here comes a Red Thunderbird. Not sure who's the Red Thunderbird, but it looks pretty nice.
Yes, it certainly does.
It's a beautiful red convertible 56, 57 Thunderbird. And they're tossing candy left and right.
Yeah.
Hopefully they're getting it close enough to the curb so it keeps the kids safe. And we've got an old Army Jeep here.
Yeah.
This looks like a rebuilt, reconditioned.
Can you see his hat?
Good, buddy.
St. Bridges School.
Oh, St. Bridges.
Okay. There's a contingent from St. Bridges School in this beautiful, beautiful
And who's
red
this
car.
Army Jeep, this reconditioned Army Jeep? We want to get a little word on that.
This is the Connecticut Valley Field Music. It's a fife and drum corps whose members play rope, tension, snare, and brass drums and wooden fifes. The musicians are dressed in 1862 replica Army uniforms and play period music, including quick steps, waltz, and spirituals.
By the way, Renee, that Jeep was 1942 World War II vintage reconditioned. Danny R. Connor, a former member of our staff, has that car.
That's cool.
Well, this sounds great.
And here is Chip Ames. He's new to the parade. He's a pirate, and he's carrying, oh no, what happened? What happened here?
It's the lost pirate.
Okay.
Whiting Lane Rockin' Readers.
Oh, right.
Gotta
wow.
I love that.
This is a terrific contingent, all dressed in orange. Take some rockin' reading suggestions from these awesome Whiting Lane Rockin' Readers who were recognized by the governor last year for 100% participation in the state summer reading program. How awesome is that?
Yeah, they all got guitars on and everything. Wow. Rockin' Readers. Reading's a wonderful thing, Renee.
It is, absolutely.
It's great that they celebrate the academics in our school system as much as they celebrate the athletics in our school system.
Absolutely.
Right.
Behind the library is a Strand Ahead.
That's a full-service hair salon offering the latest styles at reasonable prices. I wonder what they charge me for a new styling on my hair. Oh, my goodness. The Strand Ahead is hosting a meet and greet with Poppy and Branch from the movie Trolls.
Yes, and that is their theme today. You know, they always have great spirit for the parade. They really do. They put a lot of effort into their flow, into their contingent, and it's quite memorable. I'm betting they would win some kind of spirit award today.
So nice.
And here comes Zest 280, a mission-based restaurant in partnership with Community Partners in Action. Zest 280, a restaurant operates a 10-week culinary extremeship program. Hi, guys. Which trains future workers in a variety of culinary skills. Who's this? Playhouse on Park.
These are the actors from Avenue Q.
This is the Avenue Q truck.
Yeah.
I love Avenue Q.
Oh, it's sold out. It's a fabulous
I wish it was show. Running more weeks so more people could see it. It's a sold out event and to rave reviews.
And then here comes the American Legion once again, too, with some more members of their contingent. Hi, Mo.
Hi, guys.
Hi, how you doing?
Hi, how are you, Harold?
Here comes Rob the drummer.
Oh, yeah.
He's a youth motivational educator who supports the arts in West Hartford. He does that through his music, which he shares his anti-substance abuse message. He's been around for quite a while, and he can flat-out drum. Oh, I know this car. This is the Effie's Place Restaurant DeSoto.
A beautiful DeSoto. It's been in the family for generations.
And it's been in the parade for decades.
Gorgeous. Gorgeous.
There's Charlie. Hey, guys. Oh, here comes a car.
Hi, Bill.
Here comes a beautiful car, the Ford. We don't have
Brad
it listed.
Davis. Brad Davis. So
who is it?
Brad Davis is in this car. You can see him on the passenger side
Brad.
Right there. The legendary Brad Davis.
The legendary.
And that voice of his. Is
the legendary. And he comes to Park Road.
Every year
he comes to Park Road and does a show for Memphis Restaurant.
For a celebrity breakfast.
For our celebrity breakfast.
We raise a good amount of funds for this parade at that event.
And always well attended.
And he does interviews throughout the whole event. He's amazing. He really is great.
That's a Ford Fairlane 500. It looks to me to be a 1957. Good guess, right? Cub Scout Pack 145.
Yes. So boys in grades kindergarten through fifth grade can join Bugby Cub Scout Pack. Absolutely.
Good for them. It's a great organization for young men and the Girl Scouts for young ladies.
Yes, absolutely.
And here comes Trevor.
Trevor the Games Man.
Get Trevor the Games Man.
He's our favorite of the parade. Look at that. Woohoo!
How tall is he? Let's take a guess. Do you want to go out there and get measured next to him? I'll hold your mic. Go out there, right out there, get measured. Okay, Renee's going to get measured. Renee's going to get measured.
9'5".
Well, I'll give him 10 feet on that. 9.5 feet up in the air, and he walks the whole route. Uh-oh.
Oh, Manchester Regional. Fife, police and fire, pipe and drum.
I don't know what it is about pipes. But I sure love them. They're soulful and they just bring a peaceful sound to me. And you know, you always hear them at unfortunate circumstances or under unfortunate circumstances. It's glad to have them here on a day of celebration.
Absolutely. And you know, they were formed in 1953 under a different name, the Stuart Highlanders. But in the 1990s, the composition of their group changed to primarily first responders, veterans, and the like. And so they changed the name to Manchester Police and Fire Pipe Band.
Pipe Band, yeah. Well, let's listen to them. You don't often get a chance to do that. Here comes the Laz Parking.
Yeah.
And they're new to the parade this year. when we want to thank them for being a generous title sponsor of today's parade. Hi, guys. Laz Parking was founded by three lifetime friends in the mid-70s when they decided to start a valet parking business in Hartford, Boston, and San Diego. Today, Laz operates hundreds
of thousands
of thousands
parking
of
locations.
Parking spaces.
Yes.
What is this? Oh, AMR. Here comes AMR.
This is West Hartford's emergency management transporter. When, you know, people are in need, they're one of the first responders.
AMR's been around West Hartford for as long as I've been around in terms of being an adult and being aware of them.
They've coming up is the Noah Webster House, West Hartford Historical Society. The Noah Webster House is here with their contingent from their hauntings that's coming up in October, starting October 20th. If you haven't done this, it's a historic recreation of some of the residents of the old Center Cemetery. They bring them back to life. It's a really fun theatrical performance.
It's over on North Main Street.
Yes.
And it's right near my house. We see them every year. Here comes the gravedigger now. We better be careful.
And this is the Hartford Magnet Trinity College Academy Golden Phoenix Band. And they are remarkable.
Well, they're giving us a good show right now. They're 87th and 8th grade students. Boy, 7th and 8th graders marching in precision. They sound great, Renee.
Did I say that right?
Shroobrunder.
I think that means Sword Brothers, right?
We were given that bit of information, and I think
Yes, we did.
They're new to the parade this year.
They're out of Newington, Connecticut.
They're out of Newington, Connecticut, and they support German and American flag sashes and are members of the Connecticut German Clubs.
And they encourage people here in West Hartford to visit their Chris Kindle Mart on Thanksgiving weekend. And Chris Kindle Mart it takes you back 700 years in time to a medieval tradition of arts and crafts and music and artisans and pageantry and delicious German food. So please stop by 719 North Mountain Road in Newington on Thanksgiving weekend.
Chris Kindle Mart.
Which means Christmas, Mart. So they're doing a sword performance right now. American and German sashes. Looks like they're winding. And they're all together.
They put all their swords in the middle
for the finale. Oh my goodness.
He's going to stand on the swords, I'll bet.
Whoa. All right. Look at that. Oh, good for them.
Well, that's an interesting addition to the parade.
That is.
Oh, that's now they're going to unwind.
Now they're unwinding. There we go. They're all connected. Look at that. They're all intricately connected. That is pretty fun. Following them is Friends of Feeney. Returning for the second year, Eric Finney's Float. He is a teacher at Walcott School, and he is here with his friends and family and lots of community spirit. And actually, he won the Best Community Spirit Award last year.
Well, he should. It's so unusual. Here you have a little community. They get together. They build a float to come to the parade. They don't have a business here. They don't have anything here, but they love our community. So it's really good to see him here.
And that's what we encourage, you know, neighborhoods and schools to do. So, you know, so to the viewing audience, if you see something here today, think, I can do that. I'm going to get my friends and do that next year. We really want more neighborhood involvement.
That would be a wonderful thing to have. And there's so many great neighborhoods in our town. There's no reason you shouldn't get together and make a day of it.
Yeah.
Come down, do the parade, stay here for a while, maybe
sure.
have a cookout or something later in the day.
Yes.
Plenty to do in our town.
Yes.
Coogan School of Irish Dance, I'm guessing.
So this is Eric Finney's float.
Oh, this is
float.
Still Eric Finney coming
yeah.
out.
Yeah, and then followed by
them. I saw
them
all
is,
that nice green.
Yes,
all
that's right.
The Irish school.
That's right, yeah.
They have a lot of kids in that neighborhood. Look at this.
Yeah. Well, they're from Walcott School.
Good to see.
He's a teacher there.
Good to see.
Yes, and following them is the Coogan School of Irish Dance. They've been teaching in West Hartford for more than 20 years. The school trains regional, national, and world competitors. And dancers range in age from 3 to adults, and they come from towns in West Hartford and beyond. And it's their first performance in
Step
the
dancing.
Park Road Parade. Oh, they're going to put on a show now. Here.
Well, they're in front of the bandstand, so that's where you want to do it. Get your music moving. Oh, look at them go, Renee. Such great posture, huh? And footwork, my goodness.
About this year's parade is that we have a number of these stop time performances.
A lot of these dances and stuff.
Isn't it great?
I think, yeah, what an addition.
The music, the dancing, and now we're going to have another performance coming up with the Kingswood Oxford Boys A Cappella Group, and they're going to be singing to us.
Oh, they're going to give us another performance here.
Right.
Oh, look at these guys. Look at all the hairs are done up on the top of their head.
Yeah.
They're fabulous. Okay, here comes the Kingswood Oxford
yes.
Boys A Cappella
yep.
singing group.
And they got their mascot there.
And any kind of luck, they're going to stop here and give us a good song.
I hope so. I want to hear it. Here we go. Oh, they're snapping their fingers. Here we go.
Oh, we're getting a song.
The YWCA Elmwood Early Learning Center, and they're located out at Elmwood Community Center. And the center offers school readiness funding for West Hartford residents. Following them is Wands Martial Arts. This is an amazing martial arts school. I can
this is
attest
the oldest,
to.
This is the oldest and the leading provider of martial art classes in Connecticut. We're getting a display from them as we're talking. They firmly believe that the martial arts classes help their students develop skills necessary to excel in school and in life.
I firmly believe in all of that. And my children go to this school. And they're a terrific, terrific school.
Whoa. Okay, coming behind them is Daly's Moving and Storage Company. They're a long-time West Hartford business. And I'm not sure if they're
We're going to do some board breaking, huh?
Oh,
you already did it. Look at the little dragons, they call them. They're so cute.
And here's the Daly Moving and Storage truck. You need anything moved or stored today, Renee?
Okay. They're the guys to call.
I guess.
Are they located here on Park Road?
No, I think they're on South Street.
Okay, all right.
I think they used to be over on Prospect.
So here comes the Veterans Memorial Zamboni.
Zamboni, easy for you to say.
Yeah. You know, this, what's kind of funny is what's following them is the Leisure Services truck, just in case the Zamboni didn't make down Park Road.
I can't imagine why the truck's back there.
That's why. But the Veterans Memorial Ice Skating Rink offers the most public skating time in the region. They have, classes for all age groups.
Well,
and they're open year round.
250,000 skaters go there during the course of any one year.
How do you like that?
Quarter of a million people. That's a lot.
Next up is the West Hartford Fire Department, and we have our firefighter of the year, Robert Howell III, with his son today.
Well, the West Hartford Firefighter of the Year is a gentleman I've known since he was a little boy.
Oh, really?
So proud of him.
Oh.
He did such a great job.
Hi, Ryan.
Guys, how are you? Nice to see you.
Well, he was recognized for rescuing two people that were trapped on an upper floor balcony. And with disregard for his own safety, he was just driven to save those two people. And that's why he is the Firefighter of the Year this year.
He's a proud member of our force.
Yes.
Good, nice to see you.
And, of course, the parade would not be complete without a big red truck.
You think? You think? What kind of truck is this, Renee? Oh, I know what it is. We knew that was going to happen. Hey, guys. Engine one. And here comes the ladder truck, or Quint 3 from Elmwood.
Excuse me, but in this fancy car is our firefighter of the year.
Oh, he's pulling up the back
right
end
here.
Of the
here he is.
Brigade. Guys, you guys.
There, what a nice looking car that is.
Well, I've known him so long, you're going to excuse me when I go over to shake his hand. Hold the mic. It's a nice red Ford Fairlane.
Coming up is the corner pug. And, this is always a parade favorite with all the little pugs dressed in different costumes. And even the owners are dressed in costumes, too. I can see a couple skeletons there and tutus. It's just hilarious. Half of these dogs can't make it the whole route. Their little legs just can't.
They bring their carriages so for them. Yeah. These dogs were made famous in the movie Men in Black, right?
There's a stroller over there. I see it.
Somebody's in it, I think. But, look at how cute they are.
Following them is the Calvary Fellowship.
Corner Pug on New Britain Avenue in New Park. Hi, guys. Good morning.
And the Calvary Fellowship always has a rock and roll band. And they
sweetie, it's okay.
They bring great music to the parade.
Hi.
With their contemporary music. This is the Calvary Fellowship.
Calvary Fellowship.
Mm-hmm.
about it. Did you give the Hello West Hartford?
Immediately following the church is Hello West Hartford, and they have asked people of all cultures to join them here today with flags and traditional costumes. And there's over 70 languages spoken in West Hartford, and their whole purpose is to celebrate.
I wonder when was Hello West Hartford started? I remember Eileen King from the library in Elmwood was very instrumental in that. It's got to be 10 or 12 years, maybe 15. It's been quite a while now.
It's been a while.
They do a great job.
It's all volunteer based, of course.
They've got all their different flags.
Yes. And in this car right here, this fella is from WWUH Radio from the University of Hartford. Following Hello West Hartford is the Nepalese Association of Connecticut. They're one of the largest populations of Nepalese people in Connecticut are located right here in West Hartford.
In the state, right here in town. Nice to see you. Nice job, guys.
Yes.
The very peaceful people.
Yes. Following them is
West Hartford Kiwanis Club. Good to see you all.
They're one of 8,000 global Kiwanis clubs in over 90 nations.
St. Bridget School.
First year, the partnership of St. Bridget and St. Augustine.
Augustine School from Hartford. A lot of kids came. A lot of cheering and spiriting there.
Following them is Connecticut Art and Cultural Perunia. It's a group of children and adults with a passion to promote Peru's rich history. Yes, Juniper Home Care provides the best quality services to your loved ones, including companion homemaker services, personal care, and meals on wheels, gourmet meals.
They are a great supporter of all things West Hartford. Andre Burrell does a wonderful job for us. And they're glad to see them. They're almost always here. Glad to see them here this year. I hear another band coming. I know what this is.
Yes, this is the University of Hartford, the Hart School of Music Samba Band.
The Samba Band. Can we samba today on Park Road? Woo! Well, they sound good already.
Yes. They play traditional Brazilian carnival music. And special thanks today to Joel Smith of Engineer Building Products for transporting these musicians on his flatbed truck.
We'll see if they get this crowd dancing. Come on, Rachel.
To raise funds and do volunteer work to support local charities and service projects, including vision screenings, free eye exams, classes, and college scholarships.
It's good to have an organization like this in town. And here comes the Greater Hartford.
Hi, Dan.
That's a retirement treatment.
It is good, Danny. It
you're
is good.
Busier than ever.
I am.
Hey, nice to
see you. Budget printers. Okay, here's the Greater Hartford Host Lions Club. They're the ones who just did them. They do a wonderful job in helping people with eyesight, not only in Greater Hartford, but all over the world. They're renowned all around the world.
Right. And prior to them, I forgot to mention, was Budget Printers. And Dan Flatico is a great friend to Park Road and Park Street in Hartford.
And he's one of the ones that helps us keep the two, Park Street and Park Road, connected as one.
Exactly.
And it's really
wonderful
opportunity.
That's right.
But here comes the lion.
Oh, they got lion mascots. Of course they do.
Of course they've got the lions.
Yes. Following them is the Smith STEM School.
There's a STEM school, Smith, right around the corner from Park Road. This is a school that's a magnet where they teach science and math. All in their little Smith shirts, really good. Fife and Drum Corps, Windsor, always a crowd favorite. Authentic uniforms, playing authentic Revolutionary War era music. Music from the time. Let's listen. That tune, Renee.
You first, Rob.
But we know it. We don't know the name of it. That's the problem.
Following them is the Hartford Yard Goats. They are a AA minor league baseball team in the Eastern League, and the team was founded in 2016 when the New Britain Rockettes relocated to Hartford.
The Yard Goats. Everybody kind of laughed at the name originally, but everybody has adopted it and loves it, and I understand that they just are selling out the stadium night after night, and here comes Chompers and Choo Choo.
Excellent. Following them is the Ballet Theater.
Ballet Theater. Let me see if I can. West Hartford's not-for-profit ballet company and school. They're presenting the Nutcracker for the 16th straight year at the Hoffman Auditorium at the University of St. Joseph's this December. The show has become a holiday favorite for our community.
Following them is the Elmwood Community Church, known as the Little Church with the Big Heart.
That's located on Newington Road, right around the corner from New Britain Avenue in Elmwood. Little church with a big heart.
They always participate in the parade.
They do a lot of wonderful
community church.
Yeah, do a lot of little wonderful things in Elmwood community. In fact, this year they have they have a book, one of those outside book library book places.
Okay. Yes.
Hi, Susan. Hello. Adopt a family programs. I had a situation when I was with the town where we needed to get some work done in a house, and this church volunteered to come in. I spent two whole days, several of them, making repairs in this house. What a wonderful gesture on their part.
Absolutely. It was really terrific. Very nice, very nice. Here comes the town of West Hartford's Elmwood Express.
Who's driving the express these days?
Is that Bob?
It used to be Bob.
I think it still is Bob. And you know, this bus is so great because if you don't have transportation and you want to do one of the hundreds of different activities that the senior centers offer, they'll give you transportation, they'll give you a ride. So, well, you know,
and so many people need it. And I'm getting at that age myself where I could use a ride.
You got to stay
every
active.
Now and then.
Hey, Bob. No, it's not Bob.
It's not.
Experience the energy. Absolutely. That's a great motto.
Hartford.
Obedience Training Club.
Oh, isn't this interesting? We should have brought our dogs.
Yeah.
Lucky and Maggie.
Yes, that's right. They're the oldest training club in the United States in continuing existence since 1937.
Wow. We don't have any other information. I wonder, where is this club located? Are you done?
No, I'm with the Elmwood Community Center. We're running behind.
Okay. Look at all these wonderful pups coming up.
Got to carry all of this.
Good boys and girls. A lot of good boys and girls here.
Very good. Yeah. So well behaved.
Look at these guys.
So well behaved. Right. And this is the West Hartford Human Rights Commission. And their mission is to foster mutual understanding and respect among people and encourage equality of treatment of all people, of course. Here's our good friends from the commission.
It's nice to see them here. Hi.
And all right,
what's this truck?
Wexford.
Wexford.
Boys of Wexford.
Performing their Irish American music. Was that Irish enough for you, McHugh?
Yes.
They will also be performing after the parade at Effie's.
Clap.
Oh, yeah. Everybody's going to go to Effie's afterwards and listen to them perform. Why are you calling? Mike McGarry, I own
the
call.
And the West Hartford Bicycle.
Can I take over for you there?
Well, I'm not taking over there.
The West Hartford, Bike West Hartford. Yes.
Scott Franklin is the president of that. He's the one who was just talking, harassing us,
yes,
heckling us.
They strive to make West Hartford a bike-friendly community, which it certainly is. And
West Hartford Community Theater presents...
What do you think the next play will be? Could it be Once Upon a Mattress?
Well, it looks like it could be that.
Yes.
There's matinees and their evening performances. And you can find them on whtheater.org. Wow, isn't that nice?
What a beautiful float they created. Look at that. All right.
Good to see them all.
Following them is Valari's Martial Arts. It teaches character development, fitness, self-defense, while having tons of fun for students of all ages.
Nice job here.
Beautiful.
Here comes Valari's, you're right. That's right behind the little house there. Yep.
Valari's Martial Arts. And there's students.
Let's hope they don't pick on us today.
And there's Chris Olson, who runs that studio.
They've been in Elmwood for many, many, many years, down at the Elmwood Plaza. Nice.
Yes.
Oh.
And following them, look, Diane, how are you? Oh. Following them is J.P. Carroll, and he is in his stock race car, and he races his car at Lime Rock every year. He races his car, and he can bring this car up 165 miles per hour.
Not with me in it again.
Yes, and he was recently featured in West Hartford Magazine.
Sponsored by Stebbin Auto Body, one of the big sponsors here today.
I think this is Vaveline, possibly, coming up next.
Vaveline? Oil company down on Park Road?
Rob, I can't believe we're almost at the end of this parade. It's been so great.
It is always one of the best days, and it goes by in a flash, doesn't it?
It does.
It really does. And we're waiting for a couple of more contingents to come up. Why don't we go grab the mayor? I'm going to have somebody go grab the mayor and see if we can get the mayor.
So Vaveline Instant Oil Change, the number one service center for all preventative maintenance and care needs on the Park Road. On Park Road. There you go. Come in for a wash or oil change. Next
Vaveline.
Up is Colchester Continental Fife and Drum.
$2 off the car wash.
Thank you.
Well, you know my car was dirty.
Yes. Thank you. Here comes the Continental Fife and Drum. And they play martial music from yesteryear. Their uniforms are from the 1790s. How cool.
Wow. They don't look that old, those uniforms. Oh, you know what? I see Mayor Sherry Canner's coming over. Okay. See if we could grab her for a quick word or two on what a wonderful day we've had, huh? Oh, here she comes. Oh, she just got delayed by her fans. New baby, yep. Well, you know, politicians are new babies. They have to stop and kiss and give them a kiss. In the meantime, here comes the Colchester Fife and Drum.
The band, which is awesome, is a
Lydia Dahl Brothers, a fourth generation full service remodeling company, right here on Oakwood Avenue.
Lilia Dahl has been around forever.
And finally, we end the parade with Santa, of course, in Mark's Christmas Tree Shop.
Well, there's the end of the parade coming right up.
But, you know, this is a good time to talk to our mayor as we conclude this fabulous parade one more time.
Yay. It's such a great day. Look at it. We had perfect weather. No rain. No, not too sunny either. So much energy and wonderful, wonderful organizations. Great crowd. It's been great. It's been great. Thank you.
Did you have a lot of fun?
It was a blast.
I think everybody.
And now I'm hungry. I'm going to go eat somewhere on Park Road. Maybe Eppy's. I don't know.
Plenty of places to eat.
Yeah, there really are. Yeah.
Not so long ago, there were only a few.
I know. It's wonderful. It's great.
Everything's good with you?
Everything's good.
I have to comment. We stopped. You were on your way over here, and you stopped to kiss a baby.
I did.
Is that a prerequisite to be the mayor of the town?
Absolutely. And cartwheels. Did you see the cartwheel? You didn't see the cartwheel?
I didn't see the cartwheel.
What?
We'll have to check the film on that later.
Sure.
Well, thank you for helping us. Helping Park Road put this parade on every year. The town officials are so supportive of it. Everybody loves
it. It's a real group effort. There's a lot that goes into it. Thank you guys for all that you do. Yeah.
We'll see you back at next year's 20th.
Oh, no. 20th. Wow.
How about that? 20 years.
That is wild. Really. It really is wild. Yeah. Excellent. Well, great to talk to you.
Thanks for stopping by.
Nice to see you.
Bye-bye.
All right, Renee. It's a wrap.
Right. So this concludes the Park Road Parade for 2017. And give a big shout out to West Hartford Community Television.
Yo, without them, this doesn't happen.
Without their fabulous staff, they show up hours before the parade begins. They set up, rain or shine. They are dedicated, and they make this happen. And you can catch us again throughout the month of October. If you didn't get down here today, if you missed it live, you get to see it all over again.
I love your enthusiasm, Renee, but it's a great thing to be enthusiastic about. We are a better community for West Hartford Community Television.
Yes,
without them,
absolutely,
we wouldn't be the same place we are today, so we're blessed.
They are the glue that keeps us together.
They are the glue that keeps the information pumping out. I know that
absolutely.
All right, well, this crowd is dispersing. We're going to say goodbye.
We're going to say goodbye for 2017, but we
hope
back next year.
We hope to see you all next year for the 20th annual Park Road Parade.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Goodbye.